Hi everybody. Today I will give you a brief presentation about cost and time overrun management with particular reference to underground metro lines. After a short introduction, I will give some information about the methodology and data collection. Then we will continue with the project management performance of M1, M4 and M5 metro lines. After all, I will share the discussions and conclusion. The age of mega project is being experienced and scales of projects are getting larger day by day. In parallel with this growth, project goals, duration, cost and risk exposure have increased dramatically over the time. Since there are only a few studies in the literature and the risk assessment and management process is not carried out for all phases of the project, significant cost overruns are emerging in urban rail system projects. In this context, Morris states that the K factors, which are cause of cost and time overruns, are poor planning and implementation, insufficient project financing, bureaucracy, and lack of coordination between stakeholders. In this paper, the work undertakes the cost and time overrun of underground metro projects in Istanbul. There are 6 metro lines with a total length of 115.39 kilometers currently under operation in the city. And in 2019, around 500 million passengers were transported via these lines. In addition to that, a total of 227 kilometers of rail systems are planned to be constructed in the city by the end of the 2024. Considering the size of the metro projects planned to be constructed, it is seen that the past planning and implementation experiences have great importance in terms of efficient use of public resources. For the purpose described above, the scope is narrowed down to the M1 Yenikapı Atatürk Airport Kirazlı Metro Line, M4 Kadıköy Kartal Tavşantepe Metro Line, and M5 Üsküdar Ümraniye Çekmeköy Metro Line, whose total share in Istanbul metro network is about 60%. Many studies have witnessed substantial cost and time overruns and discussed the reason as to why optimistic estimations have been undertaken and what has caused the cost deviation from originally intended. The concepts of actual cost and estimated cost are discussed in order to analyze the management performance and cost overruns of projects were examined through the concepts discussed through the dozens of case studies. Besides these studies examined, and it stated that considering past studies, the statistical study with such a powerful data set and instruments could yield very clear results. The methodology here is primarily undertake an analysis from the main perspective of project management performance by employing planning and implementation performance through emerged cost and time overruns. Here, the time overrun of each project has been determined by considering the contract duration in tender phase and the project completion time. However, unlike the studies in the literature, project contract prices were used instead of the estimated cost, since the data on the estimated cost of the projects could not be accessed. Actual cost, which emerged after the cost overrun, was compared with the contract price to measure planning and implementation performance. Each instrument is discussed individually for 3 metro projects. The whole data is collected from the Istanbul Metropolitan Municipality, where authors were assigned in the Department of Rail Systems. Within this scope, all projects and correspondence about 3 metro lines in the Istanbul Metropolitan Municipality database were reviewed. In addition, a semi-structured survey was held with the technical experts, municipal officials, and other professionals who has been working on planning and implementation of urban rail systems for many years. Istanbul is the largest agglomeration and economic center of Turkey. The public transport system is mainly composed of different types of buses and minibuses, namely road type of public transport, but rail network is constantly developing since the 2000s and onwards. Considering all public transportation systems in the city, the average daily number of passengers who use public transportation was around 15 million in 2019. And the share of rail systems in this number is approximately 19%. When the number of passengers carried by the tram, funicular, cable car, and commuter rail lines operating in the city is deducted from this share, it is seen that the share of six metro lines currently under operation is 10.9%. Among the lines in the table, the cost and time overruns for Aksaray Atatürk Airport phase of M1 line, Kadıköy-Kartal phase of M4 line, and Üsküdar-Çekmeköy section of M5 line are investigated. The reason for choosing these phases for analysis is that data related to these projects can be accessed. The projects have been currently under operation and the cost and time overruns have been emerged clearly. The tenders were held in different currencies such as Turkish lira, Swiss franc, US dollar, and euro. General information about the projects and cost and time overrun values are given in the table too. The reasons of these increases in cost and time of the projects are explained in the following sections. M1 Metro Line Aksaray Atatürk Airport phase. The tender for the first phase of the M1 Metro Line was held in 1989 for around 640 million Swiss franc. The main purpose in planning of the line was to connect the historical and touristic peninsula of Istanbul to the coast station and Atatürk Airport. Construction works on the line, the contract duration of which was 1,620 days, began on May 22, 1986. The Aksaray coach station section, which constitutes the 8.6 kilometer part of the Aksaray Yenibosna phase of the metro line, was opened on December 24, 1989. Following this opening, Otogar Yenibosna section was revised. As part of this revision, the road of the section, which passes from the north of the First Ring Road, one of the main highway access of Istanbul to reach Atatürk Airport, has been changed to passing from the south of the First Ring Road. The main reason for this change was the fact that the number of passengers would be higher in the south of the First Ring Road. With the effect of this revision, the design process had been restarted. Aksaray Yenibosna phase of the project was opened on August 25th, 1995, with total contract value of around 1 billion Swiss franc due to the resulting design revision and quantity increases. Total contract value and actual project duration of Aksaray Yenibosna and Yenibosna Atatürk Havalimanı phases of the M1 metro line are summarized in Table 3. M4 Metro Line Kadıköy-Kartal phase. The tender for the first phase of the M4 Metro Line, which is the first metro line in the Istanbul's Anatolian site, was held in 2008 for around 750 million euros. The contract duration was 900 days and works started on March 23, 2008. The line was integrated with the Marmaray line crossing the Bosphorus. Besides, it was aimed to connect the high density residential areas in the east of the Anatolian site to the Bosphorus shores, which are the commercial and historical center of the city and located in the west of the Istanbul's Anatolian site. During the planning phase of Kadıköy-Kartal-Tavşantepe line, A depot and maintenance area was planned to be constructed nearby Tavşan Tepe station of the line. Also, it's planned that this depot and maintenance area construction will be carried out in parallel with the tender of the second phase of the line, and depot area works will be complete before opening. In the later stage of the construction, it was observed that the tender for Kartal Tavşan Tepe section, the second phase of the line, would be delayed. For this reason, in order to connect the line between Kadıköy and Kartal to the depot area, TBMs continued to be driven after the passing the Kartal station, and tunnel construction works between Kartal station and warehouse area were included in the scope of the contract. However, after a while, it was seen that estimated cost of the depot and maintenance area, which is planned to construct nearby Tavşan Tepe station, is extremely high due to the expropriation cost, and the design and tender process of this area was cancelled. Therefore, construction of a temporary depot and maintenance area, which is fully underground and close to Maltepe station, was included to the scope of the work, and TBMs continuing the excavation between Kartal and Tavşan Tepe were stopped and dismantled. With minor design changes and quantity increases that occurred in the addition to the two major changes listed above, Kartal Kadıköy phase of the project was opened in on August 17, 2012, with total contract value around 900 million euros. M5 Metro Line, Üsküdar Ümraniye Çekmeköy section. The tender of M5 Metro Line was held in 2011 for around 560 million euros. The contract duration was duration of project was 1,140 days, and works began on March 2012. And the reasons that emerged in the later stage of the project and led to the cost and time overrun are listed below. Quantity increases that emerged during the implementation phase of the work, change in construction methodology of Altunizade station, which was designed as a level crossing structure but was constructed as an underground station due to the lack of permission from the relevant institutions. Extension of the line length due to the change in the location of the Üsküdar switch tunnel. Change in the construction methodology of concourse level of Necip Fazıl station due to its environmental impacts. Project revisions done for design upper level of the Çekmeköy station as a car park, and additional works that emerged in the depot and maintenance area. With these major design changes and quantity increases, Üsküdar-Yamanevler section of the line was opened on the December 2017, and Yamanevler-Çekmeköy section of the line was opened on the October 2018, with the total contract value of around 670 million euros. In order to measure the planning and implementation performance of project, cost and time overrun values for the analysis parts of three metro lines given above are used through data obtained from the Istanbul Metropolitan Municipality Department of Rail Systems database and interviews. Total cost overrun ratio for Aksaray-Yeni Bosna phase of M1 line is around 70%, and time overrun is around 1,761 days. For Yeni Bosna Atatürk Airport phase for civil works of M1 line, the cost overrun ratio is around 35%, and time overrun is 222 days. And for ENM works of Yeni Bosna Atatürk Airport phase, the cost overrun ratio is around 20% and time overrun is 57 days. For M4 line, total cost overrun ratio is around 20% and time overrun is 709 days. 4M5 line, cost over run ratio is 20% and time over run is 1,266 days. When the construction process of the three metro lines is examined, it's seen that the main factor causing cost and time overrun is including additional works to project scope at the implementation stage, which are not taken into the account in the planning phase. Also, cost and time overruns emerging due to the design change resulting from these additional works, as well as increase in the quantities, have caused projects to be completed higher cost and duration than considered in the tender phase. In this study, the cost and time overruns of three metro lines constructed in Istanbul in a 30 years period are evaluated. After reviewing literature, Istanbul Metropolitan Municipality Database and holding a semi-structured survey with technical experts, municipal officials, and other professionals on cost and time overrun of three metro lines, it could be concluded that the design change could be evaluated as a major cause for cost and time overrun. This situation is thought to be the result of insufficient planning stage, the rapid and unplanned growth of the city, and the rapid change in public transportation demand. In addition, it has been determined that the quantity increases and site handover delays are other reasons affecting the cost and time overrun. In future studies, it's thought that with robuster data sets, including different case studies and the statistical analysis to be carried out for evaluating the root causes via factors such as planning, implementation, geographical conditions, financing, and line length will yield extremely good results for efficient use of public resources in urban rail system investments. Thank you so much.